My mom's fairy, my dad is princess. I grew up in a wonderland. A land of dreams, desires, aspirations, they walked me hand in hand. I felt I could conquer the world, I dreamt big, my heart swirled. I still remember the day I went to college and chose my passion. I chose what my heart desired. I was scared first, had doubts if I could, but my parents kept me inspired. I was living my dream, my life was beautiful, and then I met you. I met you and my life came to a halt. My world collapsed, my family destroyed, you ruined everything, and I don't know what was my fault. What was my fault? I still remember it was a chilly night, mid of December 2012, when I entered the bus with a friend. And you were there, waiting for me. You were six. We were two. You beat my friend, tore my clothes, ripped my honor. You pushed me in a dark world. My heart cries out loud till today. What was my fault? I begged for mercy. Please leave me. I'm like your sister. Don't do this to me. I kept crying, pleading. You did not hear a word. Your cruelty took another turn when you used the iron rod. After hours of torture, you threw my lifeless body on the road without clothes, respect, and soul. You tried to crush me under the bus once again, but I was somehow saved by my friend who was tortured and was in pain. I saw his pain when he tried to cover me, when he cried for help. People saw us, they took photos, videos, but nobody threw a shawl. I saw his pain when his helplessness and the world looked small. Next morning, people were on the roads with candles in their hands, disgust in their heart with a feeling of revolt. And there I was, struggling for life in the hospital, looking for my answer. What was my fault? Oh wait, I was soon answered. Some said it was me. I invited it on me by going out in the night. Some blamed my clothes, some blamed my parents. Some said it was the chow mein I ate, the mobile I used, the movies I watched, the breath I took. Everything was my fault. Being a girl, I should be at home. Then nobody would assault. But people forget that even kids are victimized by those animals who are everywhere. Forget about adults. Strangers, even kids, newborn and their own relatives, they don't spare. Many said I should die and not face the humiliation and pain, but I wanted to live for my parents. I wanted to live for myself. I struggled hard to breathe again. But after 13 days of struggle, I died. I died not once, but a million times when you escaped being a juvenile. When so-called fast-track court took 5 years to give verdict, I died every time I saw you smile. When the same people who marched for me marched against your capital punishment for a mile, I died a million times. I died every time I saw you smile. Now my parents don't talk much. There is no tear left in their eye. One question that keeps haunting them, why their daughter, why? They don't believe in God anymore, who couldn't help their daughter, their child who they loved the most, who was left alone to slaughter. You did not just kill me, you killed them too. What was their fault? That today their happiness, their life has come to a never-ending halt. My country named me Nirbhaya, the girl who knows no fear, but I fear, I'm scared, I'm frightened. I fear that those little girls who are living in their fairyland may one night board the same bus. I fear you might be there in the bus waiting for them. I fear you'll again rip their soul, tear their clothes, throw them in the dark vault. I fear to meet another Nirbhaya who might ask me, Didi, what was my fault?
Don't just be an onlooker. This Independence Day, take the pledge to stop sexual abuse.